I was playing basketball for the Bulleen Boomers in the Big V Championship League, and I was going up for a shot and I got some contact from behind and felt my lower part of my leg just kind of jolt out from me. The ACL stands for anterior cruciate ligament, so it's a ligament that sits in your knee and runs kind of diagonally through. It prevents this part of your leg from kind of separating here and also a bit of rotation. So I went back playing sport for 2 years, no issues, got back to playing with my same team and at the same level, and then I just started feeling a bit of a clunking feeling in my knee one game and kept playing through the game. It was a close game, important game, and then the next day I could barely walk and it was all swollen up. I'd re-torn that meniscus and all the stitching had come apart, so I had to have a second surgery. I chose to do my postgraduate study at La Trobe, firstly because I had a great undergraduate experience, and as a part of that I got exposed to the research at La Trobe through the honours degree, which is a part of the third and fourth year of the physio degree. You undertake over that 2 years a systematic review, which is basically looking at all the evidence in a particular area and then doing a research project, and that was in ACLs. And once I got that project in my third year, I'd been doing it for about 6 months, and that's when I did my ACL. So I thought I should have got some extra marks for going through the injury through it while I was studying it. One of the reasons why I think I became a physio is I was a bit cursed with injury. I had 8 broken arms as a child and 4 on each, but I was always injured and a bit of an active kid and throwing myself around. So I think that gave me a bit of exposure to physios and maybe sparked my interest in being able to fix myself. The research team here at La Trobe, we're investigating the risk factors for early arthritis following knee reconstruction, because these people have the injury when they're typically 18 to 25, so they've shown that people start to get arthritis 10 to 15 years post-surgery. So these people are, sometimes 30, 40 years old, and they've got significant arthritic changes. So trying to pick that up earlier in the process so that we can kind of give them some physio to work on the things that are going to help prolong the need to have knee replacements in an ageing population. There's wait lists for total knee replacements in the public system, so to try and reduce the amount of people that are really like dying to have these surgeries and at a young age is really not ideal.